Welcome back to my channel, and today we will be learning our journey to start Spring Boot 3 and Spring 6. So here now let's straight jump into. So if you have already set up or already downloaded the application, and if you open that application in your favorite IDE, you can open the main application, Spring Boot application. So this is the bare minimum application once you download your application from startspring.io. So before proceeding further, what we are going to do is that we are going to first create our folder structure for today's session, and also we will be using similar project to scale our project for large scale application. Now what we are going to do is that this will be a RESTful API. So we are going to create our folder structure first. I have seen many codes, many developers usually don't follow this pattern, but anytime you always have to have a proper structure. So we'll have a controller folder where we'll have all our controller, and then we will have our bean folder where we'll have all our beans. Should be just need to correct a little. Okay, so now we will create our first controller. I'm really excited about this. So now we will create our Java class, and we will name this as customer controller. Okay, so we have our customer controller class, and we are going to annotate it with our REST controller. Now next thing we are going to do is that we need to create our get method. So we'll create our method public customer, then we'll create customer method, we'll create our request parameter, and value will be name, and default value will be is equals to axis, and then it will be a string. Then what we are going to do is we'll return the value. What we are going to return, we will return our customer. I know there are errors, but it will be gone soon. And then what we are going to do is we'll come to this data. Let us create our customer bean. I'm really excited about this. Now we'll create our bean. So bean will be customer. Now this is quite exciting because we have created our class, but we are not going to use those getter and setter stuff or a Lombok library to get the create getter or setter or two string method. As we are learning latest Java version, whereas we will be using something cool here. So now usually people don't teach this, but let's see, we will use record customer, and then we'll use double string name. So this is quite cool. Now what you're going to do is, so these C errors are gone. I think there is some issue. Why like that? Okay, let us create our ID. ID will be double ID equals, we are just taking any number, math.random. You can also do something like this, something like this. And then what we're going to do is, sometimes when you write, right, the best part that when you're writing, you should not be using predefined values which are coming. I prefer to type, because then only you will remember that what means how you're going to write it, because every time you do copy paste, your brain is in a way that you will forever will doing copy pasting. You will never understand what syntax I'm writing, or you will never learn basically. Okay, so we have written our, oh, so now one thing is missing is that we need to also define our endpoint. So what will be our endpoint is, we will for now customer. Okay, so we have completed, we have annotated with the REST controller, because this is a REST API. We have created our unique ID, and then we have created our get mapping annotation, and then we have created our customer method, and where we are having a request parameter of name value, default value is hexes, and we are returning back our customer object. So our customer bean or customer object is, we are using, this is Java 9. I'll write it. This was introduced in Java 9. So this record was introduced in Java 9, and it gained popularity in Java 11 and Java 17 and upcoming versions. They have released many more functionalities in coming versions of Java, whereas I will upload a separate video of this in my another playlist. For now, we have used this feature instead of using Lombok or instead of using getter, etc. It's just one liner. Okay, if I just put it here, it will become literally one line of code. So now we are going to run our application. To run our application, we need to come here and we need to run it. So our application is started at port 8080, and now what are we going to check, that what is the output. So we'll see localhost / 8080, and then we'll type our endpoint, which is customer. Oh wow, this is cool. Okay, let me zoom a bit, so I hope you can see the value. So now we can see our value is that it is printing our ID. If this is a random ID, or it can be any UID. Basically, later we'll cover a lot of variety of IDs used, or maybe JWT token and all this stuff, but for now it is working. So we'll see that we have also defined our request parameter. This is a request parameter which will be defined as, okay, let us define it. So we'll pass name equals to what to define, maybe. So let us define the name. So you know, name variable, so we can pass like your name, see whether it will work or not. Let's see, we will hit enter and we'll see whether it will work or not. Oh, it is working. You see that the value we are passing in our request parameter is coming here, so we can pass anything like hello Java. See, it is coming, so it is working. And if we are not passing the value, it is taking the default value. It is taking default value from here, correct? It is taking the default value, which is a string. So today we have learned two things about two controller as well. One is REST controller and another is get mapping controller. In this series we will cover entire Spring Boot 3 and Spring Framework 6, all latest features with Java 17 and Java 21 as well. So just follow along and you will be building a great API which is used in an industry, and you can become a better software engineer following this guide. And if you want to more video, you can like and subscribe to my channel.